So today, I wanted to talk to you about bits and bytes. But what do we mean by bits and bytes? So on computers, we know that we have something called bits, and bits indicate an on or an off. It's a one or a zero, a plus or a minus, a true or a false. That's a bit. It's just one very simple piece of information. When we're talking about bytes, a byte is a little bit more information, and a byte is made up of 8 bits. So 8 bits to a byte. And we'll talk a little bit more about why there's 8 bits in a byte, but for now, suffice it to say, a byte can represent a single letter or a single digit of a number or a single special character like an exclamation point. So that's what a byte can represent. Now, normally when we talk about storing stuff on a computer, we don't talk about bits and bytes directly. We might talk about kilobytes, megabytes, and gigabytes. Well, that's not an A. Well, gigabytes. And maybe even terabytes. But for now, I just want to focus on kilobytes for a minute. So a kilobyte, now you may remember from your metric conversions that kilo in metric equals 1,000. It's a metric prefix. Computers use it a little bit differently. In a computer, a kilobyte is 1,024 bytes. Why not 1,000? Well, computers have to think abstractly about numbers, so in this case, what we're really doing is we're thinking about 2 to the 10 bytes. And everything is always done from 2 raised to a power when we're dealing with computers. And again, that all comes back to what a bit is, which is an on or off, 2 states. And since everything comes back to 2 states, everything is referenced to 2 raised to some power. And 2 raised to the 10th power is 1,024. Now this becomes important because when you buy stuff, you gotta look at how it's marked. Now, even 3 to 5 years ago, things were very, very poorly marked. Today they're getting better and better. Because when we talk about a kilobyte, if I'm trying to sell it to you, I might tell you, I'm gonna sell you a 1 gigabyte USB drive. Well, 1 gigabyte would be what? 1 billion bytes or 1 million kilobytes is what a gigabyte is. And if you're treated only in the metric system, then it works out nicely. But again, if I'm advertising and I might tell you it's a gigabyte, but then when the computer looks at it and you put it in, you never actually see that full gigabyte. You might only see 900 or so megabytes. And that's because the computer has to look at it as 1 kilobyte is 1,024 characters, and the manufacturer might be telling you that 1 kilobyte is 1,000. So when we divide those out, we're dividing 1 gigabyte, not by 1,000, but we're dividing 1 gigabyte by 1,024, so we end up with a smaller capacity that the computer can actually use. But that's getting a little better. Now, how much information is a kilobyte or a megabyte or a terabyte or any of this stuff? Well, for the most part, if you're dealing with text, again, 1 letter is 1 byte. So if we're dealing with a tweet would be 140 bytes at most. And it probably reserves that much space even if it's not actually if you haven't used that full capacity, but we'll talk more about reserving space in computer programs later. But if we're talking about bigger files like pictures or music or videos, I want to jump right up to videos because if we have, say, 30 minutes of HD TV or movie, that's about 1 gigabyte. So if you're downloading a 2-hour movie, you're downloading 4 gigabytes of data. Kind of crazy, right? And if we start talking about If we bump it up a level to a terabyte, which is that next 1,000 times more than a gigabyte, 1 terabyte would be the first 16 seasons of The Simpsons. And if we go to a petabyte, which would be the next step up, that would just be crazy, all right? So big things to remember, computers always think in terms of bits and bytes. A byte is 8 bits. A kilobyte is not 1,000 bytes, as we might expect from having learned metric conversions, but it is actually 1,024 bytes, which is 2 raised to the 10th power. And when you're buying media, whether it's a hard drive or you're getting RAM for your computer or a thumb drive, always make sure you look at what's written on it, because sometimes manufacturers will try and trick you by using the metric one instead of the computerese for a kilobyte, and thereby cheat you out of a little bit of space that you actually bought. And that's bits and bytes. And this is CS50X DCHS.